Let's dive into Swaroop's universe, where curiosity is knowledge.
Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today we will see N curve method, which is used to measure the noise margins in SRAM. SRAM is a memory cell, static random access memory. So why we need N curve? Why we need N curve? So we measure static this noise margins using butterfly curves also, but using this N curve, it is easy to measure. First thing, it is easy to measure. And it's an inline tester. Inline tester. By probing one of the internal node. What I mean by this is, SRAM contains both 1 and 0 on the cell, complement value also. So one of the node we will probe, and then we will then that probing will gives the noise margins, static noise margins. The internal node. So these butterfly curves gives only voltage noise margins. Only voltage noise margins. But this N curve, gives voltage noise margins as well as current noise margins also, and current noise margin also. So cells, some SRAM cells with same voltage margin, can have different current margins. So larger current margin indicates higher stability. Moreover, it provides statistical data of critical current. What is critical current? Critical current is the minimum current required for proper SRAM operation, proper memory cell operation, like proper sensing of the value stored in the SRAM array. So let's take an SRAM cell, and then we will see what this N curve is, how this N curve is plotted, and then what are the noise margins, how to get the noise margins from this N curve, noise margins and also the critical current. So what is SRAM cell? You will have an back-to-back converted, back-to-back connected inverters, back-to-back connected inverters. Let me draw the SRAM cell. So 2 PMOS, 2 NMOS. And 2 axis transistors. For these axis transistors, the word lines are connected. And this is VDD. And finally, the bit lines are connected here. These are the bit lines. So initially, the bit lines, both bit lines are charged to VDD. And this is our pull up transistors, and these are pull down transistors. So this is our SRAM cell. And for this SRAM cell, let's this SRAM cell stores 1 at this node and 0 at this node. So now we will probe one of these internal nodes. Let me probe this internal node. I am pumping this current into this node. This current I call it as I in, and voltage is V in. So initially, when we are about to read, this word lines are VDD. So this current is, this will discharge like this. So there may be some kind of some 0.2 volts is developed here, as the current is in this negative direction. So suppose if I draw this N curve is between V in and I in, this V in and this I in. So this curve, so initially there is a current, negative current flow inside the current flow. So we will have a negative current. This is IN in microampere. This is VN in volt. So we will sweep this voltage and measure the current. So this IN is noise current injected into that zero node. And this cell should be self-adjust. To get back to zero, when this noise current or injected current goes away, like when we remove that source, it should come back to zero again. So initially we have a negative current, so it is minus, it will start at minus 60 something, and then slowly if you charge, if you pump this current, then some point it will come zero, and again it will go to a peak, and then it will again drop back, and then slowly it will adjust to zero once you, when you remove this, it goes to some maximum current, and this maximum current, so this will give you this static current noise margin, and this gives you static voltage noise margin, and this peak value is critical current for read, critical current for read. These we can directly get. This curve is called N curve, because this shape is looking like N. This shape is looking like N. The shape is looking like N. And also somebody call it as noise curve, and this voltage is called right trip voltage, where the memory cell flips from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, and this maximum point is known as right trip current. This is right WTI, right trip current. This is the maximum current goes in that. Maximum negative current goes into that node. So using a N curve, for SRAM, we can find static current margin, which is not given by butterfly curves, static voltage margin, and critical currents, both for read and write by changing some bias, and right trip voltage and right trip current. This is about N curve. For more such crisp concepts, please subscribe to my channel. Please share the video with the people who want this. Please like the video. Get from the N curve. So this value will increase. So Vn we sweep and In we measure, so it will reaches a peak value where it is about to flip this value, and then this current will fall, and finally it reaches to zero after if you remove the noise voltage, which is this noise current. So to get the critical for right, we change this bias, something like this BL will be VDD only, but this BL will be zero, and then we follow the same process, then so by changing these bias conditions to BL is VDD and L bar is 0, we again measure and then we will get another N curve, and this N curve, this valley value is critical rate current. So we will get directly from this N curve. It is simple, we are probing at a node, it's easy, and then we are getting a curve, and this curve we are directly getting static noise margin, static voltage noise margin and current noise margin and critical currents for read and write. So I am ending this video here. Please subscribe to my channel. Please like the video, share with the people who likes these videos. Thank you.